Alright guys, this is a bit of a demonstration and a tutorial on phrase mixing. What we're going to do, we're going to construct a mix where it's perfectly matched, it's just in time. Now the two tunes I'm using are from a CD pool, they're from the dance releases from March 2014. On this side here I'm using track 2 from disc 2, on this side here I'm using track 10 from disc 1. So what I want to try and do is formulate some sort of mix that isn't just a beat mix. So you have outro and intro. It's the two tracks are almost intertwined, so they become one. When you make a mix, you can mix it pretty much anywhere, it doesn't matter. But it does matter. Yeah, okay. It does matter because it's got to be in time, it's got to be in key, or keys that match, and there has to be some form of construction. There's got to be some amount of gelling of the two tracks so they work well together, not only in time, but as though the phrasing is correct. This is the key, this is the important factor. So what I'm going to do, and again, now I've got loads of scribbles here. I don't know if you can see that, just loads of scribbles that I've written down. Hopefully I can remember my own writing, which is highly unlikely. Very quickly as well, I do try and do as many tutorials as I can, but I'm a working dad and it's very difficult to put the time and effort into this, because if I just sat there and just started recording stuff, it would be shit and crap. So I do try and take time in making good videos, and when I have the time I will make videos. When I don't have the time, tough, I can't do it. So first of all, I want to mix track 10 in at this point here, so have a listen. This is around about into the track, 4 minutes and 4 seconds. So this isn't the beginning of the track, it's not the end, it's the middle of the track. Now there's a lot going on here as well. Now just before that track there's a bit of a break. I want to mix this track here and I want to start the mix at that point. And I want to actually start the mix at this point in track number 10 on disc number 1. I'll go back. So I'm going to set a cue point there on that beat. So if you have a listen to this track, what I'm going to do as well now, I'm going to start to count how many bars we have before the vocals come in on that track. So, and from that point as well. So, there. So, instead of counting and hoping for the best, what I'm going to do, I'm going to get a piece of paper and a pen, and I'm going to now count the bars. It's already a top on that. Now this may seem like hard work and like, why are you making all this effort? Well, what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to construct a mix that will not only sound good, it will work well. A bit like putting building blocks together of all the same size or the same style. There's no point having blocks this big and then some that big and trying to make a perfectly matched wall, because it's going to be knobbly and all over the place. I want it so it's perfectly flat at the top, but all the bricks are neatly put together in order. So from that point I'm going to start counting bars, and every time I count one bar, which is 4 beats, 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm going to put a cross on this piece of paper. Everything will be apparent when you see what's going on. So let's just start this and shut up. Right, okay. One. Up here. There. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. four. One, two, three, 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 four. Okay, so we had vocals there, and I've counted, so if you have a look here, how many bars we've got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now, if you're new to beat mixing or phrase mixing, you'll find that 16 is quite an important number because it does seem to appear everywhere. Even in between, like, 15 and 17, it just happens to appear there. Some strange reason. So I know now I've got 16 bars to play around with before the vocals come in here. Now let's have a look and have a listen to this track here from 4 minutes and 4 seconds. And I'm going to do the same. I'm going to count 16 bars and I'm going to have a listen to what happens here. So I'm just going to put a line underneath that. And just for my reference, I will put track 10. 10. So I know track 10, 16 bars, and then if I put B for V, track 10, 16 bars, B for V before vocals. Let's have a listen to this track here. From that point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we did have a few vocals before we had the last bar in that phrase, but we had the vocals coming in completely after this amount of bars. So let's count them, first of all. We'll count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now, it doesn't take a Muppet to work this out. We have 16 bars here, we have 16 bars there. So, we have 16 bars on this track, and then the vocals come in. We have 16 bars on this track, and then we have vocals, but this track is finishing. So, of course, we want this one to come out, and we want this one to come in. Now, again, I could, if I wanted to, start these two tracks at those points straight away, and then slowly maybe bring this one into the mix. Alternatively, if I'd have beat matched them correctly and I was very quick on the cue, I could press play on their volume up, and just so long as it was perfectly in time, then they would work together, and then I would slowly then maybe take away the bass out of this track, keep the mid on, and as soon as the vocals come in on that track, bring this one out. But that's sort of difficult. What I want to do is make it a little bit easier. So I need to count back. And what I'm going to do now is track 10. I'm going to count how many bars there are from the beginning of the track before this point here where we started counting the 16 bars. So let's go back to the beginning and we're going to do the same. I'm going to turn this over and I've put B of T10, beginning of track 10. That's my reference. You could do anything. B of 10. And let's start that. And let's turn the volume up, you idiot. Oi. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Bang. Guess what? 16 bars before, well, we had 16 bars, and then we got to the point where we started counting the original 16 bars. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to go to this track, and there is a break in this track. What I will do, I'll take some pictures of the readout on the CD player, and I'll put them on my Facebook wall so you can see the construction of the wave format on here as well. Now I can see that there's a bit of a break before we got to that point where I want to start my mix, or start my complete mix where the public will be able to hear the two tracks, not maybe my mix where I'll be able to cue this one on the headphones, so I'll listen to that one on the headphones and the crowd will only be able to listen to this one until the point where I want to bring them both in. So I'm just going to wang this one back a little bit. I like wanging wellies. Wanging wellies in the wummer. No, wanging wellies in the winter, it's better. Rain, hell of a rain, we've had loads of rain. Right, so, right, that's where it's going to be brought in. So I need to bring it back slightly. So there's a break very soon, and I'm going to start counting from that break. There's a good reason, because that break probably got a construction, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be about 8 bars. Let's have a listen. Not yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now we have 8 bars here before the original 16 bars I started counting. We have 16 bars here at the beginning of the track before we got to the original 16 bars I started counting. So, what would I do? This is what I do. This track would be playing in the mix. I would then, to make it easier, I could have gone back the whole 16 bars, but because there is a break there, I can visually, which you'll see in pictures, see the break, and the break is 8 bars. I would then, on my headphones, move this track forward 8 bars. When it comes to the break, start this one off, then start to get my mix working. And then, as soon as this track comes in, on the first part of the first lot of 16 bars that I talked about earlier on in this video, which is like 5 years ago, I would then bring this one in, volume up, and start to bring my mix in. So we'll do just that. So first of all, let's imagine that this track is playing happily in the background. So that's playing. So what I need to do now with this one is count my 8 bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and that is my point. I'm going to now bring the volume up, and again, this is still playing, it's carried on playing in the background. Bring the volume down, now we'll do the mix. Again, I'm waiting for that break to come in. I can hear that in my headphones. You idiot. I missed the cue point. To be so loved, 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 So during so during that mix, I brought the bass out, and the reason for bringing the bass out during the mix is to de-emphasize this track and try and be the track that's coming, or try and make the track that's coming in be a little more prominent in the mix. Now, this may seem really long-winded, but if you do this with every single transition, jot it down, then it's a great big help. And you've also then, when you do your final mix, you've got a visual interpretation of the mix instead of you trying to remember. What's the visual interpretation? For example, you could be saying, right, track one starts from the beginning. Track two will start at 4 minutes and 30 seconds into track one, but track two will start at 2 minutes into track two. Think about it. It works because then you know when you finally do your mix, you'll know where to bring one track in and where to take the other track out. This is a talkover. Practice and enjoy. Oh, I like it. All right. Don't forget, pictures on Facebook, and check out the Dubai DJ Academy. Thank you.